In today's video, we're going to go over the updated top 5 best guns to use in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 Zombies Season 3, and make sure you guys watch until the end because there are some absolutely broken guns on this list. What is going on, guys? T-Tizzle here, bringing you another YouTube video. In today's video, we're going to go over the updated best guns to use here in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 Zombies. If you guys do enjoy this video, please consider dropping a like, leaving a comment down below telling me what your favorite gun to use is, and hitting that subscribe button so that you guys never miss another upload. And with that, let's go ahead and hop right into the top 5. Coming in at the number 5 spot and a staple for my list is going to be any gold or purple wall buy you can get in the tier 3 zone. Most players do not understand just how important the rarity of a weapon is. A gold weapon that is single pack-a-punch is a lot more powerful than a common weapon that is triple pack-a-punch, which is truly insane. And in the tier 3 zone, you can get a gold weapon for around 5,000 essence every single game without the use of a tool, which is amazing. So if you guys are playing back-to-back games and do not have any more gold or purple tools, this weapon that you can get off the wall in the tier 3 zone will be your best choice. Coming in at the number 4 spot is going to be the Renetti. At the start of the season, this weapon absolutely ran the close-range Warzone meta, and that made me want to go ahead and try it out in Zombies, and I'll be the first to say it did not disappoint. This gun has one of the best in-class mobility since it is a pistol with the damage and fire rate of an SMG, so this gun is really going to perform well whenever you're training up close with zombies, getting out of intense close-quarter situations, and even with taking out the special zombies in the game. If you guys haven't given this gun a try in Zombies, make sure you try it out and you will be mowing down the zombies in any tier in this game. And this is a class setup I recommend putting on the Renetti. So for the ammunition, you're going to want to put on the high grain rounds to optimize the damage output of the weapon. For the magazine, you're going to want to use the 50 round drum. For the conversion kit, you're just going to want to use the Jack Ferocity carbine because this is what's going to take this gun to another level and make it perform more like an SMG. For the rear grip, I'm using the Bruin Onslaught Assault Grip. This is just kind of going to help with the overall recoil control. And then optic comes down to personal preference, but for whatever reason, on this specific weapon, I really love using the Model 2023 sight. Coming in at the number 3 spot is going to be the DG LSW. This gun was buffed here in Season 3 Reloaded and has really taken this gun to a whole nother level. This is an LMG, so it is going to have a massive magazine allowing you to mow down large groups of zombies with ease before needing to reload. My favorite thing about this weapon is its overall damage output and extremely manageable recoil allowing you to take down zombies at all ranges. I would consider this weapon a Mr. Do-It-All type of weapon that is going to work great in every single scenario, making it extremely versatile. It is really good at taking out groups of zombies since it is an LMG, good at taking out high-value special targets due to its high damage output, decent mobility for it being an LMG, and a really good fire rate taking out zombies up close. So if you guys haven't tried out this weapon since the buff, make sure you give it a go because this gun is extremely good, and that is why it's earned itself the number 3 spot on this list. And this is going to be the class setup I recommend on the DG58 LSW. So for the barrel, you're going to want to use this Woody Long Barrel. For the ammunition, you're going to want to use the high grain rounds. For the magazine, you're going to want to throw on the 100 round drum. For the rear grip, you're going to want to use the second steady grip here. This is kind of just going to help with the recoil control of the weapon. And then as always, the optic comes down to personal preference, but I really enjoy the Jack glassless optic on this weapon. Coming in at the number 2 spot and probably my personal favorite gun to use due to how fun it is going to be the Akimbo WSP Swarm. This gun by itself is not the best, but when you combine this weapon with the correct conversion kit, it truly makes this weapon overpowered. Whenever you dual wield this weapon, you essentially instantly are doubling the damage and doubling the fire rate of the weapon, which just takes this gun to a whole nother level. This gun also maintains a very good mobility despite being akimbo, allowing you to maneuver and traverse the map extremely fast. The biggest issue with this gun at the end of the day is that you do need to get up close with zombies to take them down, but due to its overall damage output, this gun does not have any issues with taking out any zombies or special zombies, and even has a very fast reload speed, which has earned this weapon the number 2 spot on this list.
And this is what I would use on the WSP Swarm. So I would start with throwing on the ULO 66 laser to help with that hip recoil control, considering it is going to be akimbo and hip firing the whole time. For the barrel, I throw on the WSP Reckless 90 long barrel, just kind of help with that damage range and get more damage output out of the weapon. For the ammunition, I use the 9mm high grain rounds to also help with the damage output. For the magazine, you're going to want to use the 100 round drum. And then obviously for the conversion kit, you're going to want to use the only one we have, which is the Akimbo Brace stock.
Coming in at the number one spot and by far the best SMG in the game and overall the best current gun in the game is going to be the FJX Horus. This weapon that was added to the game here in Season 3 absolutely destroys all types of zombies, and since this is an SMG, it has a very good mobility and fire rate, helping you traverse the map and maneuver around zombies much easier. Whenever you combine the damage output along with the fire rate, this gun performs amazing in every threat level zone, so if you guys have not taken the time to unlock and level up this gun, make sure you try it out, because whenever you combine the overall damage output with the fire rate, it makes this gun truly overpowered, which is why it has earned itself the number one spot on this list.
So this is the class setup you see me use on the FJX. So for the laser, I was using this Kimora RYL33 laser sight. This really helped with the mobility, your sprint to fire speed, taxant speed, and probably why this gun was doing so good with hip firing and moving. For the barrel, I was using the SYN9 long barrel to really help with the damage output of the weapon. Same thing with the high grain rounds. I feel like they are the best ammunition to use in zombies just to help with your damage output. For the magazine, I was using the 48 round mag, and then finally for the rear grip, I was using the POC S TAC grip to help again with that sprint to fire speed, really just optimizing the mobility you can get out of this weapon.
And that is going to do it for the video, guys. Keep in mind, this is just my opinion based on my experience, so if you think I left a gun off the list, go ahead and leave it below in the comments so we can all try it out. And if you made it to the end, please go ahead and drop a like. Leave a comment down below telling me what your favorite gun is and hitting that subscribe button so that you guys never miss another upload. And with that, I'll catch you guys all in the next one.